Children, now let us see how Sri Ram is known as ideal brother. Immediately after their stay in the forest began, one fine and pleasant morning, Sri Ram and Sita were sitting on the mountain Chitrakoot, enjoying the surrounding forest and natural beauty. Sri Ram was engrossed in showing Janaki the different sights and scenes in the forest. Lakshman, as usual, was a little distance behind them, engaged in his duty of keeping a watchful eye on the surroundings. All of a sudden, Lakshman saw signs of a huge assembly of people approaching them from far. Soon, the pathway to the Chitrakoot mountain was covered with dust. Lakshman called out loudly to his brother, "Ram, a huge army complete with elephants, cavalry and chariots is approaching us. I can even see its flag and standards. The royal flag of Ayodhya is in the lead on a decorated elephant. It is clear that Bharat is coming here, fully armed, in order to finish us off." Sri Ram calmly replied, "Lakshman, do not be excited with anger. Bharat, after returning from his maternal uncle's home, is coming to meet us. Be assured that there are no feelings to deceit or enmity in his mind." "Ram, it is because of Bharat you had to forgo the kingdom of Ayodhya and undergo exile to the forests. Bharat is our enemy and I see no wrong in killing him." Lakshman, swayed by emotion, in a fit of anger, vented his feelings against Bharat. But Ram knew Bharat's innermost mind very well. He placed his hand on Lakshman's shoulder and pacified him, saying, "Lakshman, such anger is highly improper. Bharat is coming here to meet us. If you are indeed so concerned about the kingdom, I shall ask Bharat to hand over Ayodhya to you. You will yourself see that even before I complete my words, Bharat will give the kingdom to you and relieve himself of the burden." On listening to Sri Ram's reasoning, Lakshman fell into regretful silence. Upon seeing Sri Ram, Bharat ran to him like does a lost child upon seeing its mother and fell at his feet sobbing. He pleaded repeatedly with Sri Ram to return to Ayodhya, but Ram was steadfast and his refusal to break his vow of 14 years of exile. Bharat too was equally adamant that he would spend his days in exile in the forest like Sri Ram. Upon this, Ram explained the dangers of a kingdom being without a ruler for too long and the results of anarchy in a kingdom and its people. Bharat, although agreeing to return to Ayodhya with a heavy heart, refused to occupy the throne. Accepting his wish, Sri Ram gave his padukas to be placed on the throne of Ayodhya while Bharat would rule as his representative. Lesson to ponder. Sri Ram is fully aware of the nature of his brothers and knows their innermost minds very deeply. His love and concern for them is like that of a father and mother, that is, parental in nature, and hence his brothers not only obey every word of his unhesitatingly, but also are ready to stake their very lives for his sake. Refusing a whole empire for his sake, as if it were nothing more than a piece of straw, does not require even a second thought for his brothers. It is only when we have a deep and genuine affection for others, love and respect them as we would find our own selves, that others too reciprocate the same love and respect towards us. Sri Ram's love and concern for his brothers is the perfect example of this. Can we not also have the same love and concern for our brothers, even if we may not even attain the intense brotherly love of Sri Ram for his brothers Even a portion of that would enrich our lives. Difficult it may be, but by no means impossible.